Death Metal Multiverse's End Issue 1 heads to Earth 3, where Perpetua's tower imprisons all of the innocent people of Earth 0, torturing them and keeping Perpetua powered as she destroys universe after universe. Owlman asks the captured John Stewart if he thinks the people are wondering why they haven't been saved yet, but he knows they are too stupid to figure out what is actually happening. He knows the people finding out John was never there would be nice, since it would be cruel to them if they found out he was, and good never prospers in Earth 3 thanks to the crime syndicate. He gives the lantern an example, saying the champagne he's toasting with is worth $2,000 a bottle and was given to him by a prime minister so they wouldn't kill his family. But the syndicate did anyway, and the Owlman raided his wine cellar. John finds Owlman disgusting as the villain wants him to understand that he's lost. Owlman reveals that Perpetua is using the towers as tuning forks to reshape the multiverse in her image, leaving evil worlds that match her dark ideology. Planets like Earth 3 or Earth X. Owlman says that each fork is capturing psychic energy of the people from Earth 0, with their agony powering Perpetua and allowing her to destroy the worlds, leaving only 6 Earths left in the multiverse. The villain knows that the hero's plan involved gathering Justice Incarnate to save the people from the tuning forks and cut Perpetua's power, while other teams on other Earths attack the other forks. Owlman shows John one of his many weapons, a gun from Quad, whose yellow bullets will rip right through John's constructs like crepe paper. He knows if he kills the hero now, Perpetua will win, but that's where he has problems, since if Perpetua wins, they all lose. John asks the villain to help them then take down the towers, but Owlman gets sick of his self-righteousness, and the only reason John isn't dead is it's a personal matter for Owlman, who smashes the glass in his hand, since he knows how the multiverse is supposed to work, and Owlman is meant to be the darkest reflection of Batman, not the Batman who laughs from some dark multiverse. John can't believe Owlman might help them because he's feeling a little petty, angering the villain who knows without him, the heroes won't succeed, but he wants some assurances. On Earth X, Guy Gardner battles the Nazi Superman along with Captain Carrot and Kid Flash. Guy smashes Superman away with his kryptonite radiated constructs as he calls for Kid Flash to hurry things up so they can get to more worlds. Iris stops, saying that she's running so fast she can hear the dead flashes of the multiverse, demanding the man not bark orders at her since Guy still has an Earth to go home to, while her and her family were lost on her Earth. Captain Carrot knows that it's a dark moment for them all, and he can't think of a time where he was this scared or tired thanks to the physics of these worlds being different from his own. But by some miracle, they are the ones still standing and still fighting, and they need to continue to push forward as long as people are in peril. Carrot knows that Iris misses her Earth and her family, but right now there are a lot of innocent people that need Kid Flash to save the day. Iris tearfully thanks Carrot, telling Guy that she needs to open more doors by the tower, and if they can keep the Nazis off her back, she'll do it within minutes. Guy agrees as Kid Flash speeds off, leaving Lantern to thank Carrot as they head off to punch more Nazis. Guy radios into Earth 29, where Hal Jordan battles the Bizarros towards the tower, and Kyle keeps the Vampire League at bay with an artificial sun, saying next time someone else can come to the vampire world, and if he gets bitten, he's coming after the team for it. Jessica and Simon take down the Justice Lords as Jessica hopes that Kyle is joking. Simon reassures her that he is and says that their team is at the tower now, and as soon as all of the people are safely aboard the carrier, they will take the tower down. Guy knows that this will only work if all of the towers are taken down, contacting John and hoping he can hear them. On Earth 3, Ultraman battles Calvin Ellis as Owlman finds the President Superman and Wonder Woman are an impressive duo, surprised Ultraman and Superwoman haven't killed them yet, meaning the heroes are actually holding their own against them. The villain is glad since it gives him and John some time together, but John doesn't even think there is any time left, since if the towers don't fall, then Earth Zero will be destroyed along with everything else in the multiverse. Owlman says that the Justice League are responsible for unleashing Perpetua, and he wants to know everything about her and what she is. John tells Owlman the story of Perpetua and how from the source came Perpetua, who shaped with raw materials from the source the multiverse, creating the monitor, the anti-monitor, and the world forger to manage the multiverse. But soon the goddess had fulfilled her duties, but instead of returning to her usual place in the universe, she began experimenting on the people of Earth, turning them into deadly apex predators and building an army to kill anything the source may send to stop her from controlling reality. Soon her children betrayed her, sending a message to her superiors who sent a tremendous amount of energy needed to bind Perpetua, sealing her in a wall which was erected around the edge of the multiverse, separating their multiverse from the greater omniverse and the source. The multiverse healed and history began again, and Perpetua was forced to watch from the source wall as her totality was sealed away with her. Soon after, the scientist Krona tampered with the multiverse, creating the infinite multiverse of infinite worlds. Perpetua still watched on as the multiverse grew more unstable, and the only thing that could free her would be an action that would crack the foundation of reality. The first crack came with the Crisis of Infinite Earths, where the Anti-Monitor, following the whispers of his mother and unbeknownst to him, began destroying worlds. Meanwhile on Earth X, Captain Carrot directs refugees through the portals as a little girl comes up to him, thanking the hero for saving her. Carrot finds her very kind, knowing it was scary and the girl was so brave, and he doesn't think he could have done it without her. The girl thinks his fur is very soft, and Carrot reveals he uses a special carrot shampoo as he sees the girl and her father off, telling her no matter how dark it feels, the good guys always win in the end. Carrot begins to cry and Guy asks if he's okay, but the hero reveals that so many of his friends died on his home Earth, something he didn't think would have happened thanks to how physics work on his world. Carrot reveals that he was the sole survivor of Zoo Crew, picked up by the Justice Incarnate and taken to the Hall of Heroes, which was soon targeted by Perpetua. But luckily, the heroes jumped from world to world, saving who they could. But Carrot knew it was a losing battle, and he felt so hopeless until the Green Lanterns showed up, since he thought Earth Zero had been lost. Guy says Earth Zero is still pretty lost, since it's been overrun with monsters from the Dark Multiverse as well as nightmare versions of Batman, but their people now have a plan to right the wrongs. Carrot wonders if his world and the Zoo Crew will be born again when they succeed, and Guy really hopes so, and hopes that all lives are set right. Kid Flash soon arrives, telling them that something is wrong, and Guy thinks it's more Nazis, but it's even worse as Perpetua herself arrives, telling the heroes that it's useless to run from her love and judgment. She says that her allies from the Dark Multiverse will speed up the process as she unleashes the Rainbow Batman Corps, led by the Baby Batman, who demands Earth Zero and the Justice Incarnate surrender, or he will skin them all alive to make a quilt for his crib. Ultraman is told to stand down by the Rainbow Batman as they spread out to the other Earths, battling the Lanterns and the other heroes there. John tells Owlman to stop since he's had his history lesson and now it's time to act, but Owlman refuses to make a move until he understands the stakes and his place in all of it, so John still needs to convince him. John continues his long story, warning him the next bit is a bit harder to grasp since with each shift his history has changed. John explains that crises are hard to remember since they are very much like a memory of a dream, but from what he understands, the Anti-Monitor's actions in the crisis collapse the infinite multiverse into a single universe, and while reality stabilized for a time, Perpetua's source wall was cracked. Thanks to this, she was able to whisper louder into the ears of others like Parallax, Alexander Luthor, and Darkseid, causing them to commit more crisis-level events until finally her whispers reached Barbatos, who waged his own war from the Dark Multiverse. In every crisis, however, the heroes pushed back, and unbeknownst to them, every time a reality reset, a new crack formed in Perpetua's prison, and when the Justice League of Earth-Zero used Element X to lock the Dark Multiverse and Barbatos away, it ripped open the source wall, and Perpetua was finally freed. John finally finishes his story, saying he left out a whole bit about the Legion of Doom, but Owlman gets the gist, saying maybe the trick they did with Element X is why the Crime Syndicate and Earth-3 are alive. Owlman becomes angered, demanding to know what he means, so John reveals that Owlman and the other Crime Syndicate members were all killed when they invaded Earth-Zero, a while back after Earth-3 was destroyed. Owlman realizes that he's not the original Owlman as Guy's team battles the Baby Batman, who blasts the heroes with his energy weapons, cackling as the Rainbow Batman take down the Justice Incarnate and the other Lanterns. Owlman meanwhile says that he needs proof of John's claims, and luckily the man has a drive on him that came from the House of Heroes, and contains Harbinger tech that will show him all of the different iterations of the multiverse. Handing it over, Owlman boots up the drive on his computer, bringing Harbinger up and wanting to know about his predecessors. Harbinger shows him Owlman's previous three deaths, the first being in the Anti-Monitor's crisis event, the second dying when when the last survivor of the old Earth 3 instigated another crisis-level event and recreated the multiverse in its 52-universe model, and the third Owlman, who was born in the new 52 Earths, invaded Earth 0, where he was eliminated by the being known as Dr. Manhattan, to cover up Manhattan's secret meddling with the history of Earth 0. Owlman begins laughing like a maniac, freeing John and saying that he just understood something critical. Powering up his ring, John asks what the hell he's talking about, so Owlman says that with every iteration of the multiverse, if it survives, so does he. Owlman goes to see Ultraman, telling him that he's always dreamed of doing this, as he shoots the evil Superman in the chest with the quad gun, killing him before killing Superwoman as well. Wonder Woman demands to know what twisted world this is when the villain kills his own teammates, and Owlman says that it's the original twisted world, telling her and Superman to get off his planet. Superman knows Owlman took down John, not wanting to leave without their friend, so they attack the villain, telling him he's not going to murder anyone else. John arrives, stopping the battle and telling them that he will explain on the carrier, but they need to get off the world immediately. The heroes wonder about the tower, but Owlman says that that's his mission, hoping the door won't hit the heroes on the way out. Heading back to the carrier, John radios into the lanterns, telling all remaining species to get to Earth 3 now, since they only have minutes to evacuate everyone before the tower goes down. Guy contacts John, demanding to know what's going on, as Owlman sets his broadcast frequency to the correct multiversal frequency the Batmen are using, telling the one in charge that bats aren't welcome on Earth 3. Baby Batman arrives, saying his Rainbow Batman have already taken back the towers, and Owlman sided with the losers after they had already lost, wondering what kind of backwater world this is when that happens. Owlman says that this is the bad kind, as he activates a switch, which kills all of the Rainbow Batmen and blows up the towers on the other Earths, as the Baby Batman flies into a rage, smashing into Owlman and hitting him into the tower. Batman tells the villain to stop smiling as Owlman shoves the baby against the tower, saying that he's going to live forever. As long as there is a Batman in the multiverse, there has to and will be an Owlman, his true dark reflection. But the Baby Batman is dumb, and a dumb idea, and nobody will ever remember him. The tower explodes, killing both villains as Perpetua's power is finally cut off. Later on the carrier, John is reunited with Guy, who heard Owlman roughed him up a bit. John says that he's okay, and for the first time in a while, he's feeling some hope. Guy says that they aren't back home just yet, and he knows they have a big battle ahead of them. Guy knows there is something still on John's mind, so John reveals how he feels this experience has all been backwards, since if it wasn't for the original dark mirror of Batman, they never would have won and this would have all been over for them. Guy knows the multiverse does make one's head spin, since he spent the day relying on a cartoon rabbit. John knows Captain Carrot is a great guy, and Guy agrees, wondering what they're going to do with all of these heroes now. John knows they have to have hope that when everything is fixed, their world will return as Kyle returns, reporting all of the towers are down and Perpetua's batteries have been taken offline. As he welcomes Kyle back, John hopes everyone back on Earth Zero was as lucky as them, as he tells the carrier to take them on home. Death Metal Multiverse's End Issue 1 was an insanely fun, action-packed issue that followed John Stewart's team as they set about cutting off Perpetua's supply of power. I enjoyed how a lot of this issue was dedicated to kind of clearing up the timeline, not in a literal sense, but setting out a proper line of how things happened, with John telling Owlman and the reader how everything went down from Scott Snyder's Justice League. So if a new reader was to grab this issue, they would have a pretty good idea on what is happening. Justice Incarnate getting a really big push here was great, and it's one team I have thoroughly enjoyed since their inception, and they are criminally underused, so for them to get a big part in this and become something integral is so good. Owlman's portions of the book were really great as well, and I loved how even in the book references this and how a original dark inverse of Batman ends up saving the day. I thought that was a really nice parallel with all of this beginning because of a dark inverse of Batman. As I said before, this is a great issue for people who need a little bit of a reminder of what happened in Scott Snyder's Justice League run, and I'm excited to see where this team goes as they head over into another one-shot coming up, as well as Death Metal issue 4. I'm going to give this issue a 9 out of 10.